My name is William Swing. I was Bishop of California for 27 years and retired. And I'm with the United Religions Initiative. Today, with the United Nations being here, I want to tell you one thing that really struck me. On the very first minute that the United Nations met for the very first time, before there was Robert's Rules of Order, before there was a worry about translation, the first thing they did was to vote on a resolution to consider what's going to happen, because now the information about an atomic weapon is out in the world. What is going to happen to the world now that that threat is here? January the 24th, 1946, the first thing, talk about putting first things first, bring together all the nations of the world in order to address the threat to this world's survival. It might take a village to raise a child, but it takes a world of nations to figure out how not to destroy this planet. There has to be a United Nations. Here we are, 70 years later, and a former commander of the U.S. nuclear forces tells us in San Francisco this past week that there are 10 million hacking attempts launched daily. 10 million hacking attempts launched daily at the United States agencies in charge of nuclear weapons. We who have hundreds of missiles on air trigger alert could be hacked. And the missiles could be launched and detonated without anyone's authorization. If a United Nations was necessary in 1945, it is 10 million times more important to have a United Nations today. Today, you could also throw in climate change, species depletion, resource depletion, overpopulation, and on and on. The world's survival, we're not talking about security, we're talking about survival, is bigger than the security needs of any one nation. A United Nations, the only place in the world where nations meet. A United Nations is necessary. At this cathedral, we have a 12:15 service. How many attend? Oh, maybe 10, 15. But on the day after 9/11, on the next day, 6,000 people showed up. And at night, 4,000 more people showed up. When our world is threatened to the core, we need each other. We need to reach higher. We need to get beyond our arrogance. We need help that comes from powers far beyond ourselves. The United Nations is, in my opinion, the secular equivalent of our 12:15 service here at Grace Cathedral. It started out to address the world's greatest threat, did the United Nations. Here we are with a bigger threat and a bigger need. So, this afternoon we're going to be looking at the United Nations from Dag Hammarskjöld and from other angles of approach. We're going to have you, we want to hear your voice. We're going to ask you some questions in small settings. We're going to hear from you, and then we're going to have the world premiere of a beautiful piece of music that is going to be a treat for all of us. So, welcome to Grace Cathedral, a place where the UN can come back to its roots and perhaps catch its spiritual breath.